In optical fiber, what we have studied up till now is sine theta A, where theta A is acceptor angle, is equal to square root of n1 square minus n2 square. So this formula is very important. And what are the issues in this formula? Normally, this is very easy to remember, but of course, what I told you that easy to remember, easy to forget. So sometimes what happens, you in a hurry, you just write n1 square minus n2 square. Or sometimes you write this n1 minus n2 and square root, or n1 minus n2, or n1 square plus n2 square, or square root of n1 square plus n2 square. So I've seen number of students making the same mistake again and again. And even if I tell them that this is the correct formula, which is square root of n1 square minus n2 square, they will go for something else like this. So be careful while remembering this formula. This is not the correct formula. The correct one is this one. So that sine theta A is n1 square minus n2 square in square root. So let us take first problem. If the n1 is referred to index of 4, is 1.5, and n2 the refractive index of lead is 1.48, then what is the value of theta A? This is what you have to find. Go ahead. Let's solve. This is simply a calculation. So how many of you find Digi's problems as problematic? You find Digi's problem as a problem? You can just raise your hand. No one? Very good. Okay. Anyone has solved? Okay. Let me solve this. So, solution. In given problem, what you should write first as given data. Whatever is given, just write given data.
Sir, 0.7.
Okay. One answer is 0.7. Let me write answer 1 as 0.7. Okay. Any other answer, just you can disturb me anytime. There is no problem. So I'll just go on solving this. So sine theta A equal to square root of, sorry, we should write the data first, not the formula. So data is n1 equal to 1.5 and 2 equal to 1.48. So now we have to find out the theta A. So theta A is to be found out. Now we know the formula. The formula for this is sine theta A equal to square root of 1.4. Sorry, we should write the formula first. N1 square minus N2 square. And therefore, this is equal to N1 square. N1 square is 1.5 square minus 1.48 square. Now, you can just use calculator to solve this, or you can go step by step. So, for example, the 1.5 square is 2.25. Okay. I remember this, therefore, I am just writing. And what is the square of 1.48?
2.1904.
It's 2.1904, right?
Yes, sir.
2.1904. So what is the subtraction? This comes out to be square root of
0.0596.
Yes. And what is the square root of this?
2428.
Okay. Now this is the value of sine theta A. Okay. Now when you find out the value of theta A, which is equal to sine inverse of 0.2428. Now you have to remember calculator.
In the 14.05.
Just a minute. In the calculator, here it should be DEG, that is degree. Okay. This is the calculator display. So make sure that your calculator is in degree and not in radian. So it may be something like radian. We don't want radian, we want the degree. So what is the sine inverse of this? 14.518. Okay, so that is good enough, 2 digits, degree. So theta A is 14.05 degree. What does it mean? It means that this is the optical fiber, and this is core and clad, and then we have this as normal. This is the normal. And with the normal, if you incident a light on this side or this side, so this angle or this angle, any one of them, this is theta, this is theta. So any one of them will be 14.05. This is also 14.05 degree. So full angle, sometimes the question may contain the full angle, okay, full acceptance angle, which is a 2 theta A, and that will be 28.1 degree. This total angle will be the full angle, 2 theta A. So if the light is incident in this region only, it will pass through the optical fiber. Out of this, it will lost. So this is the maximum value up to which you can have the angle of incidence. Clear? Any doubt?
No, sir.
Can you solve these problems now? Is it simple?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Let us take another one, and then you can just write your answers in the. You can write the answers in the chat box. Okay. So there is another optical fiber, number 2. So the optical fiber has the refractive index of, let me write Cohr and Clad. The refracting index of clad is say 1.5, and the refractive index of Cohr is 1.53. So what is the acceptance angle? And let me ask randomly to any one of you to show what you have done. You can just type your answer, and if I ask you, then you just show me. I deliberately blocked the video from my side also, so that the bandwidth is sufficient and you can hear me properly. Okay, go ahead and solve this. By the time you solve this numerical, I will just complete your attendance. You can just reply to your attendance one by one. Roll number one, Krutika.
Present, sir.
Two, Ayush Amle. Ayush, are you speaking? Okay, I will just mark you present. I think there is some problem from your side. Ayush, outside.
Present, sir.
Number four, Vedant. Number five, Vaibhav Bhute. Number six, Atul Chaudhary. Number seven, Vedanti Chimurkar.
Present, sir.
Number eight, Karan Dhewe.
Present, sir.
Nine, Rishabh Dole. Ten, Parth.
Present, sir.
Okay, Rishabh is present.
Present, sir.
Ten, Parth Dubey.
Present, sir.
11, Vedant Duratkar.
Yes, sir.
12, Prasad Patare.
Present, sir.
13, Swarup Patwar.
Present, sir.
14, Aditi Kamble.
Present, sir.
15, Nimish Katkamwar.
Present.
16, Abhi Kumbare. Abhi Kumbare was there. Okay. 17, Manish Lakhe.
Present, sir.
18, Yash Mankar.
Yes, sir.
Then 19, Parth Mate.
Sir, Parth Mate. Present.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
You should have told me earlier. Sorry for mispronouncing. Parth Mate. 20, Ajay Nane. Twenty-one, Roshan Nidhekar.
Present, sir.
22, Yash Nikhade.
Present, sir.
23, Samir Pavankar.
Present, sir.
24, Aryan Pimpalkar.
Present, sir.
25, Prasad Kubde. 26, Rajat Yadav.
Present, sir.
27, Tejas Ranit.
Present, sir.
28, Om Raut.
Present, sir.
29, Kushan Surushe.
Present, sir.
30,
present, sir.
31, Palash Vagmare. Tejas Vagmare.
Present, sir.
33, Shesh Narayan Yadav.
Present, sir.
34, Pratik Zade. 35, Vaishnavi Zade.
Present, sir.
36, Arshan Nakpure.
Present, sir.
37, Rishikesh Shahade.
Present, sir.
38, Pavanti Mande.
Present, sir.
So some of you have written the answer and almost everybody has got 17.54547. Rishikesh, you got 17.45. Is that correct?
Yes, sir.
So there is no typing mistake, right?
Yes, sir.
Okay, Parth has said 17.51. It's quite okay. It depends on how you calculate. Yes, Karan, you want to say something? Karan, Swaroop.
It's 17.54 degree.
Okay. Karan, you want to say something? You raise your hand. So I'm just asking. Okay. So that is how we calculate. And is there anyone who has not understood and want me to explain it? Just write R if you want me to repeat this problem. Yes? No? Nobody? Okay. This is very simple actually, and I don't think there is anything that I can tell you. You already know much more about this. Now let us go for the next one. Now we know the value of sine theta A, the acceptance angle, is equal to square root of n1 square minus n2 square. Now, typically, we define a factor called as fractional refractive index. Fractional refractive index. And it is shown by delta, capital delta. And this is capital delta, okay? This is not triangle, this is capital delta. And this is defined as n1 minus n2 divided by n1. So it is something like percentage error formula. Not percentage, the error formula, like that. So n1 minus n2 divided by n1. Now once you know this, now how you can calculate or how you can find the value of sine theta in terms of fractional refractive index. Now let us start with this sine theta A equal to find. You can just write down. Solution. So sine theta A is equal to n1 square minus n2 square. Okay. So let us first take the n1 square minus n2 square. So n1 square minus n2 square. We'll just forget this square root for some time. So this you can use the identity as A square minus B square. What is the value of a square minus b square?
A plus b minus b.
Yes, it is a minus b and a plus b. So this we can write n1 plus n2 and into n1 minus n2. Now here we can assume that N1 is nearly equal to N2 because the difference is very small. And therefore, we assume it is equal to N1. Okay? Both. How we can assume this? Only for the addition. Remember. Okay, you say that. Suppose you have say 1,000 rupees and somebody else has 1,001. So you both have same amount. Okay, we can say same amount. If you are adding, then together you can have the 2,000 rupees. But when you come to the difference of 1 rupee also matters. Are you getting this point? In addition, it doesn't matter whether you have 1 or 2 rupees extra. ठीक है ना? 2,000 है, 2,001 हो जाएगा. इससे ज़्यादा क्या होगा? Okay. But when you talk about difference, then you can say that 1,001 is more than 1,000. Even if 1 rupee difference is matters. Okay. Here also, we'll talk about N1 plus N2. So this N1 plus N2 becomes N1 plus N1. Because N2 is nearly equal to N1 and therefore we take this as 2N1. Okay. Whereas N1 minus N2 will not say that N1 is nearly equal to N2 and therefore it is 0. No. We will talk about the difference. So therefore, N1 square minus N2 square will be equal to N1 plus N2 is 2N1 into N1 minus N2. Clear? Now, if you want to convert this into this delta formula, what you have to do is you have to divide by N1 and multiply by N1. So I just divide by N1 and multiply by N1. Okay? Clear? So this formula, this bracket is delta, and therefore I can write 2 N1 into N1, so N1 square delta. And taking now square root, so square root of N1 square minus N2 square equal to 2 N1 delta in square root. Sorry, N1 is outside. So 2 N1 square delta, and then we can take this N1 square outside, so N1 square root of 2 delta. Okay. So sometimes they may ask this expression so that prove that sine theta A equal to this N1 into square root of 2 delta, where delta is the fractional refractive index. And fractional refractive index is N1 minus N2 divided by N1. So in this case, it will be something like 1.5 minus 1.48 divided by 1.5. So this is something, this will be 0.02 divided by 1.5. This is very, very less. So that fractional refractive index is very less, very small. Okay? Clear? Any doubt? Any question? ठीक है
सर, फिर से
एक बार बताओ
सर, रिपीट
करो।
ओके, यस सर।
सो व्हाई वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट फ्रैक्शनल रिफ्रैक्टिव इंडेक्स, इट डिपेंड्स अपॉन फाइबर टू फाइबर, बिकॉज इन फाइबर इट इज नॉट ऑलवेज पॉसिबल टू हैव द कोर एंड क्लैड रिफ्रैक्टिव इंडेक्स एज सेम थ्रू आउट द फाइबर। अलग अलग फाइबर के लिए अलग अलग हो सकता है, but this delta will be same, delta should be same. Okay? So this is N1 minus N2 upon N1. So therefore, this fractional refractive index is defined. So it is defined as N1 minus N2 upon N1. Now let us try to find out the value of N1 minus N2 first, and then we'll divide it by N1 and multiply by N1. Okay? So we know the formula sine theta A equal to, ye cursor dikh raha hai na aapko, sin theta A equal to square root of N1 minus n1 square minus n2 square. Okay. Now let us take the right hand side and just remove the square root first. Then we'll add square root later. So we get the n1 square minus n2 square. Now n1 square minus n2 square can be written as using the formula a square minus b square equal to a plus b into a minus b. And therefore n1 square minus n2 square will be equal to n1 plus n2 into n1 minus n2. Clear? Now the difference between n1 and n2 is very small, very small. Okay, so it is just like for this example it is 0.02, and as compared to these values 1.5 and 1.4, this is very very less. Okay, so it is almost 1000 times. 1 2 3, yes, 1000 times. So therefore we can approximate that n1 is nearly equal to n2, and therefore n1 plus n2 can be written as 2n1. So n1 plus n1 here, n1 plus n2. N1 plus n1, so it becomes 2n1. Okay. Now putting this value of n1 plus n2 here in this equation, we get n1 square minus n2 square as it is equal to n1 plus n2. N1 plus n2 is 2n1. So you have to like this. Okay. Into n1 minus n2 as it is. Now we want the value of n1 minus n2 upon n1. Therefore, we are divided here by n1 and multiplied by n1. Now we know that this bracket is delta, and this becomes 2n1 into n1, that is 2n1 square delta. Now taking the square root on both sides, so square root of n1 square minus n2 square equal to square root of this. Ye pura ka pura square root mein chala jayega. Now n1 square can be taken outside of the bracket, and therefore we get the sine theta a equal to n1 square minus n2 square in the square root, and that is equal to n1 into 2 delta in square root. Okay, so remember this 2 delta is in square root, whereas n1 is not in the square root. Okay. So let us take the example. Now let us take this example from the upper one. So what was the answer? Okay, 17.54. That was 1.53. So let us take this example that the theta A, the acceptance angle, is 17.5 degree, and n1 is 1.5. So, can you find out the value of n2? And then find out the value of delta, fractional refractive index. Even if you don't know n2 value, you can find out delta. There is no problem. So what is given? See this equation. Theta A is given, L1 is given. You have to find out the 2 delta. So the equation is sine theta A equal to n1 square root of 2 delta. And if you want to find out the square root of 2 delta, which is will be equal to sine theta A divided by n1. You know theta, you know n1, you can find out this. And therefore, what are the value that comes? Just square it and divide it by 2. So squaring this, you get 2 delta. So 2 delta equal to sine theta A divided by n1 square, and therefore delta will be equal to 1 by 2 and then sine theta a divided by n1 whole square. Remember, this 1 by 2 is not inside the square. It won't be 1 by 4. So just try. Yes, anyone? Am I audible?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So we have to make sure that we are in the meeting. Okay. So 17.5 degree. So sine theta A will be equal to sine of 17.5 degree. How much it is? Sine 17.5. You need a calculator. Have you brought the scientific calculator? You should buy it. During the exam, you will not be able to okay. So Google says it is 0.3000 something. So we'll take only 0.3, and then we have delta equal to 1 by 2 and then 0.3 divided by 1.53 square. So it will be equal to 1 by 2. Now let us try to find out this one. 0.3 divided by 1.53. That comes out to be 0.196. So this is 0.196 square. That is equal to 0.0384 and divided by 2. So divided by 2 comes out to be, I'm just using the Google calculator,
0.0192.
Yes. No, it is not 192.
0.192.
Yes.
0.0
0.0192. Okay. So that is a fractional refractive index, and what will be the unit? What will be the unit?
No unit.
That is very important. So you can see, if you take it in percentage, it is 1.92. It is almost 2%. Okay. So the fractional refractive index is changing by only 2%, not more than that. It is very, very less. Okay. Now we have almost 10 to 15 minutes remaining, and let me go for the homework. So last time I had told you that you should read about the applications of lasers and optical fiber, right? And I'm sure that you have read about it. Yes. Okay, Rushabh Sheshnarayan has find out the N2 value also. Obviously. You know the N1, so you can just find out N2. Okay. That should be 1.5. Right. So let us go one by one. And let me take from the bottom, Pavanti Mandal. Please tell me the application of any one application. One is enough. Of, I think, optical fiber.
The laser.
Laser, okay. Tell me about laser.
During surgery, we can use a laser for cutting parts we required.
Okay, good.
And laser is used for cutting metals also.
Yeah, no, you should focus on the one. Let others also speak. Okay. So for surgery, yes, because its divergence is very less. So you can focus it to very small part. And how much small? You can detach the retina. Retina is very, very delicate. So you can detach the retina. Okay. So normally they, what do you call it in English? Myopia? I don't remember exactly. Moti Bindu jise kehte. I don't know the technical name.
Hypermetropia.
Okay. Whatever it will be. Because I have studied biology in 1993. I don't know anything after that. Okay. So that has the retina. There is small film of something over the retina. So you have to remove it. Okay? So that can be done with the laser. It's so specific. Okay. So let us go to Rishikesh Shahade. What do you want to say? Laser or optical fiber?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Sir, may I go with laser?
Yeah, go ahead.
Sir, it is used in barcode scanner.
Yes. And do you know which kind of laser is used there?
No, sir. I don't know the specific laser.
Mostly semiconductor laser. Mostly semiconductor. Okay, it is red color. And
yes,
it is not used directly. It is used. It is split up. It is sort of spread kiya jata, so diverge kiya jata. And then you read the barcodes from that. You can go to any shop and you can see. Basically, small malls nowadays in Vardha. You can see these barcodes scanner. Yes. Next is Harshal Nakture.
Sir, may I go to application of optical fibers?
Yes, yes. You can choose anyone. There is no problem.
It is used in our communication system.
Okay.
Via optical fiber, the data is transferred very fastly.
Yes, yes. And yes, yesterday or day before yesterday, we were talking about 300 Mbps. Okay. Yes. Practically 300 Mbps. Okay. Of course, this speed is very, very less when you talk about, for example, the CERN. You know CERN, European Center for Nuclear Research, God's Particle, Higgs Boson. Naam suna hai kuch? नहीं, उन्होंने क्या किया, दो प्रोटॉन ले लिए, ठीक है, प्रोटॉन तो पता है आप लोगों
को,
हाइड्रोजन में से एक एक इलेक्ट्रॉन निकाल दो तो प्रोटॉन बन जाएंगे, ठीक है, एंड देन दे स्ट्राइक दिस प्रोटॉन एंड दिस प्रोटॉन, और उसके बाद वहां से कितने सारे पार्टिकल्स जनरेट हुए, कि वो डेटा अगर नॉर्मल कंप्यूटर को दिया जाए प्रोसेस करने के लिए, देन दैट नॉर्मल कंप्यूटर में टेक मोर देन 100 इयर्स, इतना डेटा है, इतना डेटा, सो दैट कम्युनिकेशन शुड बी मच फास्टर एज कंपेयर टू दिस, ओके, सो देयर आल्सो दे यूज द व्हाट यू से ऑप्टिकल कम्युनिकेशन. नेक्स्ट वैष्णवी दाड़े, वैष्णवी क्या I think she got disconnected. Okay. No, she is here. Vaishnavi? Nahi? Okay, next then. Pratik Jade? Absent? Cheshna Ryan?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, go ahead.
Sir, I am talking about optical fiber.
Okay.
Sir, optical fibers are used in telecommunication field to transfer information from one place to another. It is also used in secure information in a military and other offices.
Yes. Why it is used in military? Do you know?
Sir, it is means to secure information.
Yes, it is secure information as compared to the copper cable. It is very secure. Not so secure. ये जो हैकिंग वगैरह होता है, वेबसाइट हैकिंग, तो दैट इज हैपनिंग, बट नाउडेज वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट क्वांटम कंप्यूटेशन, तो क्वांटम कंप्यूटेशन विल बी हाईली सिक्योर, थ्योरेटिकली इट विल बी इम्पॉसिबल टू क्रैक इट, समटाइम्स वी विल टॉक अबाउट क्वांटम कम्युनिकेशन, इट्स क्वाइट कॉम्प्लिकेटेड. ओके, नेक्स्ट इज तेजस वाघमारे. तेजस आर यू देयर? Yes, we can't hear you.
Sir. Network problem.
Okay.
I am go ahead. Talking about laser.
Okay.
It is used in cutting, or medical. Medical.
No. Go for only one. Okay. Cutting. Cutting what?
Cutting like hard disk material, diamond,
yes.
Metals,
yes.
Or some critical material or designing.
Good.
In designing or other something.
Yeah. So why it is used for cutting? Because it can produce the heat. It is so intense that it will produce the heat, and that heat will take out the material from that particular point. Okay. So you can practically drill or cut any material.
Drill or Good. Cut.
Yeah, you want to say more?
No, sir.
Okay, good. And next is Prathamesh Thale. Prathamesh, I'm not sure whether the network is good or on your end. Prathamesh is there?
Yes, sir.
Okay, we can hear you. Go ahead.
Sir, may I go to for application of optical fiber?
Yes, go ahead, no problem.
Optical fiber is used by telecommunication companies to transmit telephone signals, internet communication, and cable television signals. It is also used in other industries, including medical, defense, and industrial and commercial. In addition to it is used as a light guide for imaging tools and lasers.
What is imaging tool? See, whatever you are saying, you should know about it slightly. Okay? Imaging means creating an image, just like your camera. Okay?
Yes, sir.
You take the mobile, you yes, take sir. The photo. So using the laser, you are imaging, you are taking the photograph. But where? किसका फोटो लेते हैं लेजर जैसे हम मोबाइल से अपना सेल्फी लेते हैं वैसे लेजर से सेल्फी ले सकते हैं नहीं दैट इज फॉर इनर ऑर्गन्स इनर ऑर्गन्स जो है फॉर एग्जांपल किडनी और हार्ट दे आर डेलिकेट सो यू इंसर्ट द फाइबर एंड देन यू यूज वेरी लो पावर लेजर एंड यू जस्ट सी or you take just take the image of that particular part and then you study and then you see malignant cells malignant matlab jo kharab hue theek hai aur uske baad uski surgery karte hain next you can switch off your mic ketan surush ketan are you there
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Sir, I am talking about laser.
Okay.
Laser are used in manufacturing. For example, welding, sir.
Yes, welding. And how this welding is different than the normal welding? Any idea?
Sir, in highly capacity manufacturing, like medical and automotive industry
no we just talk about welding that's it what I am trying to do is I am just trying to get some application from you only one application okay? and if you don't know more details I will tell you welding kaise karte hai jaise normal welding mein kya hota hai ki there is some material okay welding material and that binds to two different materials okay So in case of laser, you just heat these two materials, and once they are hot, they will be joined without any third object. इसमें कोई भी नहीं होता, welding material कोई नहीं use करता, ठीक है? So this welding is very very strong, specifically for it is used for those materials for which welding is very difficult. For example, aluminium. Aluminium के लिए आप normally weld नहीं कर सकते, ठीक है? So you can use the laser.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Next, Om Raut.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Go ahead.
Sir, laser is used for scanners, scanning papers or printers. Use hota hai usko.
Yes. Very good. The scanner. There are two types of scanner. Eye scanner and face scanner. So in scanner you can use it, and why the laser in laser printer? Why the laser printing is very accurate or much beautiful as compared to the desk jet? Okay? Because the laser is very fine. Okay.
Yes, sir.
Next, we'll take only two for today. Tejas Ranit.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Tell me any application of optic fiber or laser.
Sir, I will tell about optic fiber.
Okay.
They are used in broadcast communications. First, RJ cables were used through transmission. Nowadays, the HDMI cables are used for transmissions.
Quite good. Quite nice. So you can send the data. From one place to other very quickly.
Yes, sir.
We'll stop here for this question answer. Let me ask you, how many of you have seen the documentary on transatlantic fiber cable. Okay, only one. Rajat has raised the hand. Nobody else? Okay, Om also has raised the hand. Anyone else? You should go for it. See, you have enough time, more than enough time. So just watch it. This is very, very interesting. Okay, let us stop here. And is there anyone who has reported late? Vedant Bomnote, Vaibhav Bhute, Atul Chaudhary, Ajay Nane, Prasad Kubde, Palash Vagmare, and Pratik Zade. No? Okay. They are marked as absent. Whosoever has told the application of laser or optical fiber, they will get one mark each as a bonus. Those who are not spoken, they will not get the marks. Okay. And the remaining students will go for another question. Just you have to speak for a minute or two. Okay?
Okay, sir. No problem.
See you then.
Thank you, sir. See you.
Bye-bye.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.